Well, for more on this, I'm joined by Shyla Raghav, Climate Change Lead at Conservation International. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
So as we know, the president did follow through on his campaign promise to pull the country out of the Paris Accord. Who are the biggest winners and losers from this decision?
Well, let me just start by saying that I'm deeply disappointed by President Trump's decision to withdraw the United States from the Paris Agreement. Having been part of the Paris process and actually being in Paris myself, it was a carefully negotiated agreement that took many years. And also every country that was there with good intentions. I would go as far to say that there are no winners with this decision. We're at a crucial, critical point in history where we need to see global emissions peak in 2020 if we have any chance of meeting the goals laid out in the Paris Agreement. Now, this isn't just an arbitrary goal. It's a goal that was guided by science, and it's guided by our need to limit the most harmful impacts of climate change, whether it's mass migrations, sea level rise, mass famine, extinction of species. And so while this decision will also have ramifications around the world, it also will be very detrimental and damaging to the United States, weaken our position at the global stage, threaten our national and economic security, also reduce our ability to support developing countries in meeting their commitments.
Now, on the flip side of that, though, President Trump did say it was more about this idea of kind of comparing the U.S. to other countries that are getting to construct more coal plants. He named China, the U.K., and also India. So in terms of the coal miners, which were his rallying base, is it not considered a win for them?
I would argue, actually, that the coal industry is actually being outperformed by renewable industry and renewable energy. In 2016 alone, 10 million new jobs were created. At the same time, 440,000 jobs were lost in the coal industry. So the evidence, the data is clear that the train has left the platform, it's left the station, and the global economy is on a path towards decarbonization.
And to that point, in February, the U.S. Department of Energy's report showed that clean energy jobs actually outpaced fossil fuel industry jobs by 5-1. So what does this mean for the future of the clean energy industry when it comes to the future of its competitiveness in the U.S.?
I think it'll continue to grow. I would implore that there be continued investment in research and development, that the private sector also step up and provide more impetus, more research, and more momentum towards bringing these solutions to scale.
And how likely do you think are we going to see some perhaps more countries who agreed in Paris but perhaps haven't ratified it yet? How likely are we to see them backtrack?
Well, I actually think that quite the contrary. And we've already seen countries like China and India have reaffirmed their commitment to meeting their targets set out in Paris. Also, we might see collaborations, bilateral unions, like between the European Union and China, to work together and actually ramp up and ratchet up their commitments in the absence of United States leadership.
Now, one of the arguments Trump had was that the U.S. is basically doing enough. The companies are already doing enough that they don't need to be governed by the Paris Accord. In terms of the companies who, regardless of what Trump is doing, said they are going to meet their own clean energy goals, how much of a difference does it make them with the U.S. coming out of this?
I think that the private sector has again reaffirmed its commitment, and this is evidenced by the number of companies that came out with declarations and very firm statements imploring the president to stay in the agreement. Because it's important for U.S. competitiveness, it's important for the United States to have a say in how the global markets are shaped and formed. And so I think that while it is disappointing that the United States is not at the table in determining how the United States can play into those international trends, the private sector has the ability to continue and to ramp up their action to meet their own commitments that are science-based.
Now, you have two of the world's biggest carbon emitters. You have the U.S., you have China, now taking these very divergent rules. As you mentioned, China reaffirming its role, also supported by the EU and other countries. What does pulling the US out of this accord mean in terms of the leadership that's being taken and having that seat at the table when it comes to clean energy right. and the future of the environment?
Yeah, so it means that other countries will have to assume more leadership. But I think the biggest piece is where the financial resource is going to come from. I think a lot of countries relied on the United States to not only provide the symbolic leadership, but also do its part in providing the financial resources to allow developing countries to not only reduce their emissions, but adapt to the impacts of climate change. So I think there will need to be more focus on financial incentives, but also other countries coming up with creative, innovative instruments from the private sector, for example, to be able to meet that unmet demand and need for resources.
We'll certainly have to see how the consequences play out. Thank you so much, Shyla Raghav, Climate Change Lead at Conservation International.